you know, we clap our hands and everything, but I need you like you're in a football stadium. How we holler. Hey! So I'm going to say hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It is so good to see you again. This time, face to face. Amen? Hallelujah. I mean, we see a lot of Facebook and a lot of messages through the phone, but it's nothing like seeing you face to face. And we just truly want to say thank you. Y'all, we miss y'all. We love y'all. Oh, and it's just so good to come back into the service again. Amen?
Amen.
Come on, guys. Y'all stand with me. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
This is a little song. I'm not even going to say it long. Jesus. And that's what we're going to do, because we're going to call the name of Jesus as we pray.
Once again, we did this in June, and all that week it was hot. Things were just really uncomfortable, and all of a sudden on Sunday, God made it to where it was comfortable back in June. But look what He did today. I don't know if everyone really noticed what He did today. Amen. There were two hurricanes about to come this way. God stationed a low pressure or whatever it was, cold front, to steer it in the other direction. Do you know? Do you see what God has done? Amen. Our God is able. Amen. God is able. When we look and we thank God, we got to know exactly what we're thanking God for. Amen.
Yes.
We are thanking God for life, health, and strength.
Yes.
We are thanking Lord, the Lord for providing a way, amen, and making a way out of no way. We got to just say thank you, Lord.
Thank
Somebody
you.
Just say thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Well, at this time, we're going to follow the service. Amen. We're going to start off with Pastor Fulton, if you're ready to come, and he's going to do a double Sunday school. Amen. He's going to do last week's Sunday school and this week's Sunday school, and he's going to do it in a timely manner. Amen. Somebody say amen.
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 Amen. Amen. But like I said, we got a double hitter for you this morning. Our first lesson is David, King over all of Israel. And the second Sunday school lesson is God provides manna for manna and quail. Amen. Let's pray. Just stand with, just stay there and just let's pray with the Father in the name of Jesus. Lord, we want to thank you for this day. Come, Holy Spirit, help us, teach us, Holy Spirit, to understand your word and get knowledge of your word. In the name of Jesus, allow your word to go forward, God, in Jesus' precious name. Amen and amen. Amen. Okay, we're going to get that dive into the lesson this morning. You know, when I was studying these Sunday school lessons, I looked at the title, but I said, let me see what the principle is, what the principle of the lesson is. I know we got the aims, and it says the facts, and the principle, and the application, but I want to see the principle what God is speaking to me about. So in the first Sunday school lesson, David, king over all Israel. Our lesson text is 2 Samuel chapter 5, verse 1 through 10. Our aim is fact to be reminded that learning to wait on God is an essential aspect of the Christian life. Principle, to realize that waiting on God increases our faith in Him. Application, to trust in God's love for us instead of growing impatient with Him. Our outline, the tribes assembled, the king's anointed, Jerusalem claimed, our golden text, and David went on and grew great, and the Lord God of hosts was with him. In 2 Samuel chapter 5, verse 10. Now, the principle of this lesson that I see is waiting. You know, sometimes waiting is good, but then again, it's not good. Depends on the situation. Waiting develops patience, because the Bible says in James chapter 4, chapter 1, verse 4, but let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. So how do we display this patience? First, we thank God. The Bible says to rejoice in the Lord. Second, we seek the purpose while we wait for the Lord. Amen? We wait on a lot of things. Amen? We wait to go to school, we wait to get up, we wait to go to sleep, we wait for our paycheck, we get our bank account. We wait for a lot of things, am I right? Are y'all with me this morning? Is everybody here? Okay. Well, Brother Lewis put up a lot of mics, maybe we need to pass the mics around.
All right.
What does waiting mean with God? What does waiting on God mean? We wait on the Lord to answer our prayer, to tell us what to do. We wait on Him because He is God. Amen? And we are not. As we wait on the Lord, He changes us and strengthens us as we wait. We don't want to get ahead of God. Now, David waited a long time in his journey to become king over Israel. God appointed David over the tribe of Judah and to be king over all Israel. But that took a long time for God to bring him to that point. So, in other words, God has assigned us to a lot of things and got us to, for things to do for Him too. But for us to get us there, He has to prepare us. Amen? That's why David took a long time to be over the whole Israel. So the tribes assembled together. Now, the people made it clear that they wanted someone like David to lead them, to be their king. Amen? When they voiced their concerns. The people wanted someone who could lead them, feed them, and lead them as a shepherd to lead his flock. But the journey is what David learned in, and that's what we have to learn. God has chosen you and me to get, He's given us an assignment, and no one else can take our place for that assignment, no matter what. Amen? No matter what, no one can take that place. And what God has chosen you to do, that's what the question we're asked this morning. What have God has assigned you to do for Him? It's time to wait on God and not place yourself in position. You find a lot of people place themselves in position, give themselves titles, and God did not place them there. Amen? We have to wait on God. That's a part of a Christian life, is waiting on God. Now, the facts here is to be reminded that learning to wait on God is essential and aspect of the Christian life.
Amen.
But King David was anointed king. After the death of Saul, there was a hunger for power for Saul's throne. Not everyone agreed that throne belongs to David, despite God's decree and Samuel anointing him as Saul's replacement. But Saul's commander appointed his son over the tribes of Israel. But David was anointed with oil to establish his office. And this was actually the third time David was anointed king. First, he was anointed king over Judah. Then he was, he was anointed king when he was a boy. Then he was anointed king when he was over Judah. Now he was anointed king over the whole tribe of Israel. Now, I'm going to show you, when you came into the body of Christ, when you got saved, you have three anointings too. Some of us got one because we just got saved. Some of us got two because we're growing. Some of us got three because we are mature. Amen? The first anointing was the leper's anointing when you got saved. The second anointing was the priestly anointing. The third one was the king's anointing. See, David was selected by God as king long before he took on this role as king over Israel. Now, Paul was chosen too by God, but he didn't know it until he got converted from his mother's womb. That's when he realized that God had called him, amen, to reach the Gentiles. But David was acknowledged as king by the people. Now, when Jesus came on the scene, he was not acknowledged as king, amen? But Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Can I get amen?
Amen.
In his second coming, all will bow down before him and confess him as Lord. Everyone who rejected him or not, they will bow down to him. Amen. But that doesn't mean those who rejected him is going to be saved. Amen. Because some of them said to Christ, think they got a fireproof plan. But that's not it. You got to grow in Christ. Amen?
Amen.
The principles of this lesson, to realize that waiting on God increases our faith in him. Jerusalem claimed. David decided to attack the city of Jerusalem and to make it the capital of the nation. Jerusalem was not always under the Israelites. It was by the Jebusites. Amen? David defeated the Jebusites, finishing the work that the children of Israel were supposed to have done in the beginning. He was being obedient for the original plan that God had already told him to destroy all of everything that wasn't of God, the habitation of Canaan. Amen? The application of this is to trust God's love for us instead of growing impatient with him. This is what the Israelites did when they didn't finish the job, because they became impatient. They said, well, we got what we want, that's it. Don't just settle for less. Amen? Just because you got saved, don't just settle for I'm saved. But look for the blessings of God on your life, including this first lesson. David waited a long time to become king over Israel. He went through a lot of pitfalls, including attacks on his life. Satan hates people when God uses them for his purpose, amen? Satan will come and try to stop God's plan in your life. He uses that weapon of discouragement, fear, unbelief, and try to stop God's plan from unfolding in your life. But never give up, amen? Wait on the Lord. Don't try to place yourself in position. I want to ask you a question. Have you ever waited a long time for something to happen?
Amen.
That's very important to you that you want to happen? I know I have.
Amen.
I guess I'm the only one. And Mr. Jolene.
Amen.
Waiting on God can be frustrating. Amen. Because he don't work on our schedule. He works on his schedule. And I get
amen.
But he promised that he will strengthen us if we wait on him. He promised that he will answer our prayers and meet all our needs. Amen. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31, but those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. This lesson this morning, this first lesson, we should learn something from it on wait on God. Amen. And not trying to go ahead of God. Amen. I'm going to tell you this here. This way you reach your destiny. If you haven't learned that, you need to start back over. Because what you learn is when you're on that journey. Amen? But you know what? God loves the children of Israel, and he loves us too. Amen? And God has protected them. He has given them victory. He's given them grace. But now he's going to feed them manna and quail. And our lesson text is Exodus chapter 16, verse 2 through 15. Our aim is to see that the Lord provides for the needs of his people. Principle, to understand how God taught his children to obey him. Application, to personally learn obedience from God's work in our life. Amen. Our outline. The people complain. The Lord's response. The Lord's provision. The principle of this lesson is complaining. How many in here this morning have ever complained?
A lot.
I know I have. Amen. But God wants to teach the children of Israel. Amen. He had to teach the children of Israel how to follow him and how to follow his appointed leaders, Moses and Aaron. They had to be taught godly morals and ethics and values. Amen. The Israelites needed to become a functioning society that could reflect their godly character. Amen. They had no idea when they were coming from Egypt what God expected of them. Even when we got saved, we have no idea what God wants us to do. Amen. All we know, we're saved and we love God and we want to do God's work. So I know that's the way I feel. Come on back here. Okay. Yeah, if Peter came back, I'd have left it.
Yeah, I
don't need you. Amen. That's it. That's where we were. Where we were. They had no idea. Amen. But they had to learn when they started their journey to the promised land. They had to learn obedience and how to obey God. Amen. Same with me. When a child is born, a little child is born, the child does not know how to be obedient. He has to be taught how to be obedient. But when a child is born, a child will do everything that is not obedient, that he's not supposed to do. Can I get amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. They will have to become God's people in thought and in deed. Yep. Now, the children of Israel were 6 weeks out of Egypt, and they became hungry. And then they began to complain. God would use that opportunity to teach them to listen to him and obey him. Same with us. We have to learn how to obey. No matter we get hungry or our wants and we're not getting it right then, we still have to learn because God wants us to learn. Amen? God wants to teach us. The people complain. You know, when one person starts complaining, everybody starts complaining. That's why complaining is not good. Can I get amen?
Amen.
The Israelites headed to the wilderness. Only 3 days after their song of praise at the Red Sea, they found themselves without drinking water. And then they began to murmur against Moses and Aaron. Amen. That will become a habit for the children of Israel. And a lot of people are picking up that same habit, everything they complain about. It's nothing right with them. They complain, complain, and complain, and complain, and complain. But the people blame Moses and Aaron for deliberately bringing them into the wilderness to die of hunger. This is what a lot of people think. I shouldn't have come to the Lord. I should have stayed out here. I'm in jail all the time. I'm always sick. I'm always this. I don't ever have nothing. I can't pay my rent. When I wasn't in the Lord, I could pay my rent. But you have to wait on the Lord.
Amen.
And stop complaining.
Amen.
Because God knows your need. He knows what you're going through.
Amen.
He sees everything. And it's nothing hidden from him. Amen.
Amen.
As I said, the hardship that they went through because of their complaining, most of it they brought on themselves, it caused them to lose all perspective, who they was in Christ and who they are in Christ. There is an important lesson here for us to learn. When we take our eyes off the Lord and focus on our problems, we lose all perspective that we are children of God, that God loves us. Amen?
Amen.
We usually seek something or someone to blame, or we wallow in our self-pity and accomplish nothing. And we blame everybody else or the situation. Our problems or situation should cause us to focus, refocus on the Lord, trusting and praising him, knowing that there is divine purpose in everything that's going on in our lives. Amen?
Amen.
The fact here is to see that the Lord provides for the needs of his people as he provides for us each and every day. For 67 years he's been providing for me. Amen?
Amen.
The Lord responds. The Lord responds. The people had complained that they had lack of meat and bread. God was teaching them a belief, amen, that he was their only provider, the one who from heaven gave them not what they expected, but what they really needed. And that's what some of our problems are.
Yeah.
We want what we expect and not what we really need, amen.
Come on.
God wants to teach us, but that was going to be a test. And it was a test, not just a test, but it was a test of faith. Amen. Well, they're going to put their faith in him. It was just a test to see if they would follow instructions, but a test to see if their heart was willing and free to be a covenant people for him. Amen. The test would also involve faith. The people would have to trust God for their daily provision. Do you trust God for your daily provision? Amen. This did not justify their complaint trying to manipulate God, rather than God would want them to remember that he knew their heart, as he knew our heart. And he knew their needs, as he knew our needs. Their complaint was actually against God, not against Moses and Aaron. And if we complain, it's not against the mama, it's not against the job, it's not against the world, it's not against the teacher, it's against God. Amen?
Amen.
The principle here is to understand how God taught his children to obey him. Provision. The Lord reassured the people of Israel that that in the evening they would eat meat, and in the morning they would have abundance of bread. This was a reminder of how gracious God was providing for them. Amen? Their wants. Although they complained and they grumbled, but God still met their needs. He gave them meat and he gave them bread for 40 years.
Amen.
For 40 years he continued to provide for them. Some of us are more like the children of Israel. God is meeting our needs. I'm coming to a close. God is giving our wants too.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
But we continue to complain.
That's right.
We continue to grumble when things don't go our way. Just like the children of Israel. Some of us don't even want to admit it. I mean, a lot of I don't complain, I don't grumble, I just tell the facts. Well, the application here is to personally learn obedience from God working in your life. Amen.
Amen.
Know that God is working in your life.
Amen.
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 God remind them that he is Almighty God, that he is their provider. Amen.
Amen.
I want you to take a look at your life experience in closing. Are you convinced God is your provider? Let's remember that we may not know how God will provide, but he is our sovereign God who knows what we need and will make provision for those needs that we need. Amen?
Amen.
We as God's children can walk in obedience and he will provide for our needs.
Yes.
The Israelites learned obedience to be prepared to obey the law. We learn from scripture that will drive our faith in God's provision to handle any problem of sin that comes our way.
Yes.
We must make sure we understand and believe that the Father sent his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, to save us, that God is our Creator, and that we owe him our total love and obedience. Amen?
Amen.
In closing, the scripture says in Philippians chapter 2, verse 14 and 15, do everything without complaining and arguing, so that no one can criticize you. Live clean, innocent, live as children of God. Shine like bright light in a world full of crooked and perverted people. Amen.
Amen.
Stop complaining.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank y'all.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Aren't y'all glad we don't just have to praise God on the inside? We can praise him right here in the yard. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Our God is greater. Some of y'all know about this. Y'all can see him. Y'all seen him work through this pandemic. That he's a great God. That he's a healing God. That he is a providing God.
Oh yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Water has turned into wine. Eyes of the blind, there's no one like you, none like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise, there's no one like you.
Y'all know that they didn't hit us? Do y'all know why they didn't hit us?
No, it's because
of, yes, amen.
Our God is greater.
It's because of that, and it's because of the prayers of the saints.
Yeah.
It's the prayers of the saints. It's for no other reason.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I just thank God that we're all here to come to service today and to be blessed, and it's good to see everybody here today.
Amen.
Y'all know out in the world we've lost a lot of important people, a lot of people that was important to the world, a lot of people that we weren't expected to lose. We lost football players this year. 2020 was a very trying year. We've lost basketball players, Kobe Bryant and others.
Yeah.
We've lost prominent actors. We've lost people. We've lost people in the ministry. We've lost a lot of bishops. I think we lost over 12 due to the COVID virus in the Church of God in Christ denomination.
But we know that God is yet with us, and that the reason that we're still here today is because of Him. Amen?
Amen.
And then, lately, the last person that we lost was a guy by the name of the Black Panther. Chadwick Boseman. And we know that a phrase that he used a lot was, Wakanda forever.
Yeah.
Well, I want y'all to know today is Jesus forever.
Yeah.
Jesus forever. Can I get everybody to shout? Jesus forever. He's the reason that we're here. He's the reason that we have life, breath, and health, and that we still make it. Amen? So that's your encouragement word for today. I want everybody to be blessed.
Thank you. Jesus forever.
Jesus forever. Now we have our scripture reading for today. It's coming out of Acts 17 and 28. 17 and 28. Short and sweet today. For in Him we live and move and have our being. As certain also of your own poets have said, for we have also His offspring. Amen. May God add a blessing to the reading of His word.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Minister Dwayne and Pastor Fulton with the Sunday school. Amen. I just pray that everyone is comfortable. Yesterday we tried to prepare. We sprayed mosquito spray out yesterday evening and mosquito spray this morning. We had to try to make sure, we tried to make it comfortable for everyone. Amen. So I just thank God for allowing us to be here, and I just pray that everyone is comfortable. Amen. I know the heat is coming on a little bit, but thank God it's not like it has been. Amen. I coach football, and it's been hot. Today it's pretty good. Amen. I thank God for this blessing. Amen. Some comfortable weather. Amen. Amen. Well, at this time, we're going to have our praise team come back up for another song. Amen. Amen. Now, we are also going to have communion right after service today. Immediately after, Mr. Tyrone will be leading the communion. And then after that, we're going to have offering. You're going to have an offering as we complete communion. On your way out, we're going to have you to give your offering then. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Come on.
Father God, thank you for providing a nice weather, a day, Father God, for us to come and serve and worship.
crazy. Father God, we can't take it for granted because it could have been hurricanes, it could have been storms, it could have been flooding, it could have been all kinds of stuff, Father God. But you saw fit. You had your angels to hold it back.
Hold it back.
Hallelujah. So thank you, Lord, for holding it back. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And Father God, we are glad to be in the service. And Father God, we are coming to give a sacrifice of praise. A sacrifice of worship, Father God. Oh, Lord, if we can just say hallelujah. If we can wave our hands, Father God. Oh, God, if we can just wave our hands and say hallelujah. Glory to God, Father God. Will you give us the activity of our limbs, Father God? Oh, God, you give us clothes on our back, Father God. Food to eat. Oh, Father, through this pandemic, through the last few months, Father God, it's been rough, but you still provided a way. Oh, God, you sent manna down from heaven to all of us, Master. Father, through the form of food or money or whatever it may be, you made a way, Father God. And we just want to say thank you for the manna. Oh, God, we just want to give you glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' precious name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Well, I just thank God for all of you being here today. This is such a blessing. Amen. To see everyone. And you know, this is family. This is our family. And when you are not around family, you miss family.
That's right.
Amen. So it's good to have family back together today. It's been really crazy. It's been crazy. And I know some of the kids right here in front of me know that it's been crazy with the virtual learning. Amen. We got teachers frustrated because they can't get technology out. We got kids and parents frustrated because they can't get technology in. Amen. We got all kinds of stuff going on with Zoom. Amen. And I thought about the song on Zoom, the Commodores. Zoom, I'd like to fly away. Y'all remember that? Said, I'd like to fly away. Well, I think somebody felt like flying away when they was messing with that Zoom this week because it crashed and you couldn't get in on Zoom. So we all felt like flying away. Amen. Amen. And then I thought about Aretha Franklin's song, Zoom. Also, amen. Who's zooming who?
Yeah.
Amen. Who's zooming who? We can zoom. Everybody got Zoom. Amen. So who's zooming who?
Zooming Jesus.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. We're zooming Jesus. I like that. We're zooming Jesus. I like that. Amen. But you know, the level of frustration has just been really, really high, especially in the education system. Frustration among the parents. We have a lot of parents that's been trying to help their kids do they work. And in Galveston, we have something called Canvas. And I think other places, they use other type of different things that they put their work in, that the kids have to send work in. It's just been frustrating. And the parents have been frustrated trying to help the kids because the parents have to help them log on. We got little kindergarten and first grade kids that don't know how to log on. So the parents are having to do that, having to teach the lesson because the teachers don't have an opportunity to go out and teach. So they are frustrated. So the parents are frustrated. Then you got frustrated among the older children. You got older children that have little siblings that they're trying to help get their work done, and they still got their own work to get done. Amen. So you got frustration there. You know, then you got frustration among the little bitty kids because they don't know what to do. And then one of my grandkids did his work, got his work done and everything, and hit the wrong button and lost everything. He was frustrated. So it's been so much frustration. And then there's another level of frustration when Zoom don't work.
Yeah.
Amen. When Canvas don't work, or whatever you're using, Microsoft, social media you're using to get your work done. Amen. It's a double level of frustration. And then it's so bad that we have teachers that have quit.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Quit the education system. There's been teachers that have been crying, frustrated, coming out of the hallways frustrated. Yep. We got kids that's crying. We got parents that's crying and frustrated. We got parents that's at home. They're able to stay at home and do their work on their computer, but they can't get their work done because they're helping their kids get their work done.
Exactly.
Amen. So it's so much frustration.
Right.
So much frustration. And you know, throughout the week, I was trying to ask the Lord, okay, Lord, what do I need to preach about? Amen. There's so much going on. What do your people need to hear? Father God, you give us what to teach about. So I went through, I was thinking about the sermon today was going to be Acts 13:6-1. Acts 13:6, that was going to be the sermon. That's not the sermon. And that was going to talk about just how Paul was able to come. He was in a group of people and he had a sorcerer in front of him named Elymas. And Elymas was trying to stop the other man from hearing what Paul had to say. And so what Paul did, Paul believed in the Holy Spirit and he was filled with the Holy Spirit. And so through the filling of the Holy Spirit, he looked straight at that man that was stopping the word of God from going. He looked straight at him and told him, you're going to be blind. And the man went blind. The man went blind. Amen. So that's somebody that's filled with the Holy Spirit. You know, and I was going to preach about the title of that sermon was going to be The Stare. See, Paul stared at him. And when Paul stared at him intently, looked at him intently, that's when the Holy Spirit worked through him and the man became blind. Well, I thought about my mama. My mama used to have that stare on me too.
Uh-oh.
I tell you, my mama, if I was acting up in church and acting up somewhere, my mama put that stare on me.
And I'm like, oh no, what's going to happen now? And then she hit me upside the head and I was blind for a while. Amen. I got blind for a while and I came back to my senses. Amen. Amen. But that was the staff. The staff. That was going to be the title of that sermon. And then I thought about, okay, Lord, what else could we talk about? So I was going to talk about the power of the Holy Spirit that resides in the believer. The power of the Holy Spirit that resides in the believer. And the title of that sermon was going to be, He or She Ain't to Be Messed With. He or she ain't to be messed with. Do y'all know some people in the Bible that wasn't to be messed with? Amen. David and Goliath. That Goliath should have let the man alone. He wasn't to be messed with. Amen. Amen. Moses wasn't to be messed with. Pharaoh wanted to mess with Moses, but Moses wasn't to be messed with. Amen. Amen. Then you got different people like Samson. Samson was, now they talk about Samson being a big, muscular, strong man, but Samson, they didn't never say that. It never said that about Samson. He just said the Spirit came upon him, and he was able to do amazing feats. Amen. So he didn't have to be all muscular or anything like that. The Lord can use you the way you are. Amen. The way you are. The Holy Spirit can work inside of you the way you are. Amen. So that's what the title of the lesson was going to be. He ain't to be messed with. She ain't to be messed with. My grandmother was like 4'10". I don't know. Both my grandmothers was short. And with somebody, I've seen her, I've seen my grandfather get my grandmother upset. Get her mad, get her upset, and all she did was pray. And when she prayed, something would happen to my grandfather. He'd get like a pain, or something would happen. See, my grandmother wasn't to be messed with.
Right.
Amen. She wasn't to be messed with. She was a woman of God. And there are people right now, you all possess the power of the Holy Spirit. You ain't to be messed with. You got people on your job to try to mess with you. You ain't to be messed with. Children, you got people at your school, them bullies and messy people that's trying to start mess. You ain't to be messed with. Because you got the Holy Spirit all upon you. Amen. Amen. So you ain't to be messed with. So that was going to be the message. Amen. But that's not the message. Amen. But that's going to be the message in the future. All right. Amen. So, but you know, many Christians don't believe in the power of the Holy Spirit. They don't believe in the power of the Holy Spirit. Many Christians preach the Word of God, they read the Word of God, but they leave the part about the Holy Spirit out. They're saying that the Holy Spirit can't do certain things nowadays. That was only during the Old Testament he was able to do that. Or only during the early church that he was able to do that. I never saw where the Holy Spirit stopped doing that. I never saw where the Holy Spirit stopped giving miracles. Amen. I never saw when somebody prayed for somebody to be healed and the Holy Spirit worked through them. I never saw that stop. It still works right now. There's still some praying going on. There's still some praying and some healing going on. Amen. By men and women of God who will believe in the Holy Spirit. Amen. Who believe in the Holy Spirit. Now, you can preach the Word of God all you want to.
That's right.
Amen. You can read the Bible all you want to. But if you don't believe in the power of the Holy Spirit, then you don't have the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. And to do anything, you've got to have the power
of the Holy Spirit.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. So we got to believe in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Right.
Well, now I'm going to go into the book of Acts, and we get ready to go to the side of our message, and I won't be here long. During this time of pandemic, there's so much going on around this world, not just the pandemic. There's still so much happening. There's national unrest. I don't know if you realize all of the protests are still going on, amen, with the police brutality, the racial injustice, everything that's still happening in this country. There's so much going on. The disconnection in many areas of society. The issues in the church. There are a lot of different things going on in the church. There are a lot of preachers and pastors around here preaching something other than the gospel of Christ. Amen. Sure. They're preaching all kinds of stuff. And then the Pastor Wesley and there's two other pastors, Pastor Melanson and Pastor Green. We get together every Wednesday and we have an hour Zoom meeting. And we're just talking about different topics in the Bible. And Pastor Wesley brought up the conversation the other night of the New Age religion. The New Age religion. It's a new religion that's out there that they pick and choose what they want to take out of the Bible. You know, I can pick this here, this, I'm going to use this one here, but I don't believe in that. You can't pick and choose in the Bible. Amen. The Bible is a whole Bible. Amen. It's not a half Bible or a part Bible. You've got to believe in the whole Bible. If you don't believe in the whole Bible, you don't have the whole God. Amen.
Amen.
You want the whole God, you want the Holy Spirit, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you've got to believe in every word that's in the book. Amen. You've got to believe in every word. If you want the power of God, you've got to believe in the power of God. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. If you leave any of them out, you don't have the power of God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, today I'm going to talk about the message that I'm going to talk about. I'm coming from Acts chapter 17, verse 28. And I'm going to read a little bit longer than that, though. It'll be Acts chapter 17, verse 28. And it reads, "For in him we live and move and have our being, as certain also of your own poets have said, for we are also his offspring." The title of today's sermon is, It's All About Him. Mm. it's all about him. Who am I talking about?
Jesus.
I'm talking about Jesus. Amen. It's all about him. It's all about God, the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. It's all about him. Amen. And you know, coming from the church that we came from, the carpenter's house, Pastor Pope used to lead off with a song. He used to always sing, and we were doing Bible study or whatever we were doing. He was saying, in him we live.
Amen.
In him we move. In him we have our being. You might as well not move at all unless you move in him. We used to hear that. We used to sing that so much, and I thought about that song is so true. In him we live, in him we move, and in him we have our being. It's all about him.
Yeah.
It's all about him. Amen. Amen. Then there was another song that we used to sing at Progressive Baptist Church. My cousin, he's still over there at Progressive. Progressive Baptist Church, we used to sing a song. Without God, I could do nothing.
Yeah.
Without him, I would fail. Without him, my life would be rugged, like a ship without a sail. Amen. Without God, we can do nothing but fail. Amen. Without God, we can do nothing but fail. It's all about him. It's all about him. Now, in the book of Isaiah 26, the book of Isaiah 26, verses 3 through 4, you can find it later, and I'm going to try to rush along. It says that thou will keep him in perfect peace, those whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusted in thee. Trust ye in the Lord forever, for in the Lord Jehovah is everlasting strength. Because he trusted in thee. He trusted in who? He trusted in him. You trust in who? We trust in him. Amen. That's how we have perfect peace. Thou will keep us in perfect peace, those whose mind is stayed on him. Amen. Amen. And you know, I'm talking about him. I'm talking about, I keep saying about him. It's all about him. And you know, it reminds me of the little children. When kids are little and they don't really know how to use he and him, and you'll ask them, who hit you? Him hit me. Him hit me. Or who gave you that toy? Him gave me that toy. Amen. Well, to you all, I'm going to use some ingrammatical words. Amen. Because who gave you life, health, and strength this morning?
Yeah.
Him. Amen. Who gave you food to eat?
Yeah.
Him. Who healed your body when you were sick?
Yeah.
Him. Amen. Who did it?
Yeah.
Him did it. Amen. Him did it. We sound like the little children, but him did it. Amen.
Yeah.
Him did it. Amen. Amen. It's all about him.
Yeah.
It's all about him. Now, just going through how we are with God, on your job, in your home, wherever you're at, you preach the word of God. You represent God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. You represent him everywhere we go. Amen. So as Paul was preaching, he was preaching in this synagogue, and some listened, but some were jealous and wanted to start trouble for Paul and Silas. It's people like that that don't want to hear the word of God. The much as we preach, the much as we try to walk around and live a Christ-like life, there's somebody out there that want to mess you up. There's somebody whose main prime target is to mess your day up. Amen. Somebody's out there watching you to see, and they're looking for your weaknesses, to see how weak you are, to see what I can do to press buttons to mess them up. Amen. But when we deal with the Holy Spirit, amen, when we believe in God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, we ain't to be messed with. We ain't to be messed with, amen. Because we are praying stuff up on him, amen. Amen. Have y'all ever heard of imprecatory prayers? David did a few of those, where he prayed certain things on certain people. Did you see what Paul did to the man? He blinded the man. He prayed, that's basically an imprecatory prayer right there, that he caused something to happen to that person. You don't have to go out there and try to slap and kick nobody outside of here.
Yeah.
Leave it to the Lord. Amen. You pray on that thing. I think God can do it better than you can. What do you think?
Amen.
Amen. You think, I think God can handle a situation better than you can. What do you think?
Amen.
Amen. We got to believe in who? In him.
Yeah.
We got to believe in him. Amen. Amen. Now, as we move on. Now, so we see Paul went to preach, and now he left Thessalonica, and he went to preach in another place. The place is called Berea. Amen. I remember Dr. J and I was talking about the Bereans. The Bereans of a group. Now, what he did, he preached over there, but they studied everything that he talked about. They studied everything that he was preached about, the Bereans. We have to all try to be Bereans. You can't listen to all these conspiracy theories that's going on, all this preaching that's going on the internet, all kinds of stuff, all kind of crazy doctrine that's going on. We've got to search the scriptures ourselves. Be a Berean.
That's right.
Be a Berean and see what's being said. Amen. See if it lines up with the Word of God. If it don't line up with the Word of God, you got to let that go.
Man.
We can't take those conspiracies and all this stuff we're hearing on the online. You can't. All that stuff ain't true.
Amen.
Go to the Word of God yourself.
Amen.
Pray to God to give you some understanding, to open up the Word that you may gain understanding. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Be a Berean.
Amen.
Be a Berean. Amen. So now he went to Berea. Now he's getting ready to go to Athens. Now he's traveling. Now Paul ain't being lazy. Paul ain't just sitting around not doing nothing, twiddling his thumbs. Paul is being about his Father's business. That's what we got to be about, our Father's business. So Paul shows up in Athens next. And there he saw all these different idols. America, we can't talk about Athens. Because we got all kinds of different idols too, that we make gods out of. Amen. After this pandemic happened, we saw a lot of those idols get shut down.
Yeah.
Amen. You saw all of the basketball, the sports, and the athletics, all that stuff got shut down. The entertainment got shut down. Some of those things, people were making them idols. And God said, oh yeah, I'm a jealous God. I'm going to shut that down. And God shut it down. And you know what? If we go back to serving idols, if this country does that again, God going to shut it down again. Amen. Because we serve a jealous God. Amen.
Amen.
God, and he's the only one that should get any type of worship.
Amen.
Amen. We don't worship idols. So Paul gets there in Athens. He sees that they're worshiping different idols. And then, so what next thing Paul does, he saw all the idols in the city, and he debated with the Epicureans. There was a group of people that were Epicureans. They were like thrill seekers. They were people that were seeking pleasure from different places. Amen. Seeking pleasures from different places. Amen. Instead of seeking pleasure from God. Amen. Seeking pleasure from different places. So that is the Epicureans. Then we had the Stoics. The Stoics. You all that's getting ready to go to college, let me tell you right now, amen. I know Samara and some of you all are getting ready. Jeremiah, you guys are in college and going, getting ready to go to college. There are Stoics in the college. Do you know what a Stoic is? A Stoic is someone that's a philosopher. They practice thoughts. They're all about thoughts. You know, I'm the great philosopher and I know everything. I'm all about thoughts. So you got that in college also. You're going to have some people that's going to come up against you to try to sway you, to try to get you off of the Word of God and saying, oh no, there's no real God. How could there be a God? There's the Big Bang theory. Amen. There's no theory. There's a theory of evolution. There's no creation. Amen. So you got people that's going to be really, and they're really persuasive. They'll try to find all kinds of ways to persuade you to leave God. Amen. But we got to stand strong. Just like Paul did. Paul was not swayed. Amen. Matter of fact, he converted some of them. Amen. So you can convert some of them. Amen. Amen. So you stand strong in the Word of God. Amen. So we see that the Stoics were there also. And then there were so many learned people, the smart ones. They thought Paul was tripping. They was like, who are you talking about, Jesus Christ? Paul, what are you talking about? A Messiah? What? He's supposed to come, but he ain't coming yet. These great people thought Paul was tripping. But Paul stood strong. Paul believed in him. Amen. He believed in him. So as he was going around, he was looking at the different gods. And he noticed that one of the gods there, it has the God, the unknown God. He saw Mars, and he saw all these other different gods, but he saw one idol, one place that said to the unknown God. And Paul said, that's the one. That's the one I want to talk to you about. The unknown God. The thing that you don't know much about it because you haven't tried to understand it. You haven't tried to go into it. Amen. You haven't tried to study it. And you got to seek for him. You got to seek for God. You got to reach for God to get God. Amen. Amen. You got to make sure all of that stuff is left behind. All the philosophy stuff, and you give it all to God. In him, we live. In him, we move. And in him, we have our being. Amen. We've got to search for God. Amen. So just looking at Acts chapter 17, 22 to 34, and I won't be long, y'all. I know we have to do the communion, but Acts chapter 17, I'm going to read a few things here. I'm going to start at verse 22. It says, so Paul, standing before the council, addressed them as follows. Men of Athens, I noticed that you are very religious in every way. For as I was walking along, I saw your many shrines, and one of your altars had this inscription on it, to an unknown God. This God whom you worship without knowing is the one I'm telling you about. Verse 24, he is the God who made the world and everything in it. Since he is Lord of heaven and earth, he doesn't live in man-made temples. And human hands can't serve his needs, for he has no needs. He himself gives life and breath to everything, and he satisfies every need. From one man he created all the nations throughout the whole earth. He decided beforehand when they should rise and fall. Amen. He decided beforehand when they should rise and fall. America is a great country. And we've been hearing, let's make America great again. You cannot make America great again until you go to God. Amen? You got to go to God. This nation has to go to God. Because God already knows, He already said that nations are set up and nations fall based on what God wants. Amen? He's already planned it. Amen? So United States, we got to stay in God we trust. Amen. We got to stay in one nation under God and not take God out of the pledge of allegiance, not take God out of anything. Amen? Amen. So moving on, verse 27. His purpose was for the nations to seek after God and perhaps feel their way toward Him. Nations seek after God. This country has to seek after God. Amen. And without God, we can do nothing but fail. The country can do nothing but fail. We've got to seek after God. It says, feel their way toward Him and find Him. Though He is not far from any one of us. God is not somewhere off in the distant space and all over the place like that. God is God. We are in God. Amen. God is everywhere. We are in God. Amen. It's not we got to go over there and see God or go over there and see God. No, God is here. God is there. God is everywhere. Amen. We've got to know that God is everywhere. Amen. And it says verse 28. For in Him we live and move and exist. As some of your own poets have said, we are His offspring. And since this is true, we shouldn't think of God as an idol designed by craftsmen from gold or silver or stone. Now, listen to verse 30. Listen to verse 30. God overlooked people's ignorance about these things in earlier times. God overlooked certain things in earlier times because they didn't know certain things. God, there were certain things that weren't revealed to them. Right now, God has left us the Bible. Everything that we need is in the Bible. Everything that we need, so they didn't have it back then. So God overlooked certain things. Amen. But God is not overlooking. If you've got an opportunity to word, to learn the Word of God, to seek God's Word, God holds you responsible for that. Amen. Right. Amen. In Him we live, in Him we move, in Him we have our being. Amen. We've got to trust the Lord, and we've got to seek the Lord. It says God overlooked people's ignorance about those things in earlier times. But now, He commands everyone, everywhere, to repent of their sins and turn to Him. For He has set a day for judging the world with justice by the man He has appointed. And He approved to everyone who this is by raising Him from the dead. Who did He raise from the dead? Amen. Jesus. Amen. Amen. Him. Amen. He raised Him from the dead. Amen. So I'm almost finished. Almost finished. It's because of God that we live. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, 19 through 20, what? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and you are not your own? We are not even our own. In Him, we live. Without Him, we don't live. Amen. In Him, we live. In Him, we move. Without Him, we don't move. In Him, we have our being. Without Him, we don't have our being. Amen. It says that we belong to God, and we are not of our own. For ye are bought with a price. Who bought that? Who bought us with a price? Jesus. Amen. Amen. Somebody, who bought us with a price?
Jesus.
Amen. Amen. In Him. Amen. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Your body and your spirit belongs to God. Amen. And we don't trust in anything else, but we trust in the Lord. Amen. Amen. Now I'm almost finished, but I want to just go right here for a minute. Now we've gotten it all twisted. We've gotten it all twisted. Amen. It says, now listen to the media. Boy, I listen to CNN and stuff like that. I got to turn that stuff off sometimes. Yeah. They tell you all kind of stuff, y'all. We got to turn those news off. Turn it off sometimes. Because sometimes the news will give you something on a slant. Something that they want you to believe in. And they have ways of doing it too.
Yeah.
And they'll hide truths and build up lies. Amen. Yeah. They do all kind of stuff like that. So we've got to trust God. We got to pray to God before we watch any type of CNN or MSNBC, all of that. Amen.
Amen.
Listen to the media. Some begin to think in coronavirus we live. In coronavirus we move. In coronavirus we have our being. No. No. It says in God we live. In Him we trust. In Him we live. In Him we move. In Him we have our being. Coronavirus is something that God allowed to be here, but we don't fear coronavirus. We don't fear it. Amen. We are not moved by coronavirus. We're moved by the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Coronavirus is there, but God is in control of all things. Do you know that God controls coronavirus? Amen. Do you know that God controls every little disease, every little small, minute, single-cell animals, all the way to the furthest reaches of space? God, that's from the smallest thing to the largest thing to the furthest thing away. It's all about Jesus. It's all about Him. Amen. 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 So listen to the media. In coronavirus we live, in coronavirus we move. And there's something, not just the coronavirus. Some believe it's in our spouse we live. In our spouse we move. In our spouse we have our being. No. We follow our spouse as they follow Christ.
Amen.
Amen. If they're not following Christ, then we don't follow them. Amen. Because we still in Him, not my wife, not my spouse, not your husband. Amen. In Him, we live. In Him, we move. In Him, we have our being. If you trust in the Lord, then everything else is going to work out.
Amen.
Amen. Trust in the Lord, it's going to all fall into place. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. In Him. In Him. Some believe we trust in our bank accounts, in our jobs, and our bosses on our jobs. Amen. All kinds of stuff. We believe that we live, move, and have our being in all these different things. Some believe that we might as well not move at all unless we move in our homeboys. Unless we move in our friends. Unless we move in other things. No. Unless we move in Him. In Him. Amen. Amen. Moving on. Some believe that it's technology, that we live, move, and have our being. Amen. We trust in things like the technology and other things. We are trusting in a creation and not trusting in the creator. Amen.
Right.
A creation will fail you every time. A creation is always subject to fall. A creation is always subject to mess up. But our creator is never going to fall. Our creator will never fail. Amen. In Him, we live. In Him, we move. In Him, we have our being. You might as well not move at all unless you move in Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We got to trust in the Lord. Amen. Romans 1 and 25, it says they worship the created things instead and rather than the creator. Amen. Then we got to know who created everything. Amen. John 1 and 3, it says all things were made by Him, and without Him was not made anything that was made. By who? By Him. It was made by Him. Amen. Him. It's all about Him. It's all about Him. It's in the Lord. It's in God we trust. In God we live. In God we move. And in God we have our being. It's in Him we live, move, and have our being. It's all about Him. If it's not all about Him, let me tell you what happens when it's not all about Him. When it's not all about Him, we are susceptible for all things to enter. If it's not all about Him, we are susceptible. If it's not about Him, fear can enter. Amen. If it's not all about Him, fear can enter. If it's not all about Him, worry can enter. If it's not all about Him, frustration can enter. And you teachers and you children, you know about that. You've been dealing with that. It's all about Him. Amen. If it's not all about Him, hopelessness can enter. If it's not all about Him, burdens can enter. If it's not all about Him, heavy loads can enter. If it's not all about Him, mental issues can enter. Oh, but I heard somebody say that Him is a heart fixer. Amen.
Yeah.
That Him is a mind regulator.
Yeah.
Amen. And Him is a burden bearer.
Yeah.
Amen. And Him is a heavy load sharer.
Yeah.
Amen. In Him, it's all about Him. It's all about Him. Turn it over to the Lord. Turn it over to the Lord and He'll work it out. Oh, yeah. Amen. Turn it over to the Lord. But when it's not all about Him, we fall into every wind of doctrine. Amen. The New Age religion. Amen. If it's not all about Him, as Pastor Wesley was talking about that New Age religion, if it's not all about Him, you're going to fall into every wind of doctrine. Anything can come your way because it's not all about Him. Amen. If it's not all about Him, we fall into all of these kind of false conspiracies that's going on. If it's not all about Him, the false teachings that's going on. If it's not all about Him. But church, it's all about Him.
Yeah.
Who is Him? Who is Him?
Jesus.
Let me ask again. Who is Him?
Jesus.
One more time. Who is Him?
Jesus.
He's bread when I'm hungry. Who is Him?
Jesus.
He's water when I'm thirsty. Who is Him?
Jesus.
He's my joy and sorrow. Who is Him? He's hope for tomorrow. Who is Him? Who is it all about?
Jesus.
It's all about Him. Amen. It's all about Him. I'm almost done. It's all about Him. Who spared my life? Him. Amen. Who brought you out of darkness into the marvelous light? Him. Amen. Amen. When you were down to your last dime, didn't know nobody could step in on time. Who stepped in on time? Him. Amen. Him. Somebody been there. I think somebody know what I'm talking about. Amen. Amen. What's His name?
Jesus.
I say, what's His name?
Jesus.
Amen. It was Him who died on the cross. Amen. It was Him on that old rugged cross. Amen. It was Him who died. It was Him who rose. It was Him who rose again. It's Him that sits by the right hand of the Father. It's Him that I might have the right to the tree of life because of Him. Amen. It's all about Him. It's Him we move. In Him we live. Amen. In Him we have our being.
Yeah.
You know something, y'all? None of us knows what tomorrow holds. But all of us should know who holds tomorrow.
Amen.
Amen. Him holds tomorrow. Good God Almighty. It's Him. It's Him who holds tomorrow. Amen. It's Him who holds. It's Him that we live. It's him that we move, and it's him that we have our being. Amen. If you want to know something more about him, you need to go to Psalms 103 and just read it in its entirety. Read Psalms 103 and find out what the Lord has done for you, what him has done for you. Good God Almighty, what God has done for you. Amen. Find out about it. And then if you don't have a shout, something's wrong with you. Amen. If you don't have a shout in your heart after you know what God has done for you and still doing for you, amen. If you don't have a shout in your heart, amen, you ought to just shout. Shout. Tell the world how good God has been to you. Of the goodness of Jesus. Of the goodness of him. Of him. Amen. Who died for you?
Jesus.
Amen. Who's looking at, who's sitting at the right hand of the Father for you right now?
Jesus.
Amen. Who's providing? Who gave you food to eat?
Jesus.
Water to drink?
Jesus.
Who provided shelter over your house? Amen.
Jesus.
Clothes on your back?
Jesus.
Oh, it's all about him. It's all about him. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's time to shout. Shout. Let it all out. Hallelujah. God has been so good. Hallelujah. God has been so good. Hallelujah. God has been so good. It's all about him. In him we live.
Amen.
And in him we move. And in him we have our being. You might as well not move at all.
Amen.
Unless you move in him.
Yes.
Amen. The doors of church open. Amen. There's one who would like to come to give yourself, give your life to Christ, and be able to have eternal life with him. Amen. Give your life to Christ. Amen. In him we live, we move, and have our being. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's all about him. It's all about him. Amen. It's all about him. Yes. Amen. Exiting, amen. And just to let you know, we are in the process of doing some different things. Whosoever will, there's some buildings that we've been looking at, and there's some other things we've been talking about, and then maybe even renovating here. There's different things that we are in the process of doing. And the Holy Spirit is leading us. He's going to lead us in the right direction because it's in him that we live, move, and have our being. We are not going to make any decisions on our own. It's going to be through him, by him, and for him. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to have Mr. Tyrone come on up.
Amen. Amen. What an awesome word, y'all.
Amen.
That was an awesome word. Yeah. Please.
Amen.
Give him glory and praise.
Yeah.
It's a blessing to be able to praise even in the pandemic.
That's right.
We can praise in the pandemic, y'all.
Yeah.
Woo.
Yeah.
Man. My.
You can
praise him when the light's out.
Yeah.
You can praise him when we don't have a dollar, a dime, or a name.
Because it's all about
him.
It's all about him. Glory to God.
Word.
You made me want to get up and swing. Run. I said, please sit still. It's too hot. Sit down somewhere. Glory to God. Glory to God. Well, it's that time, y'all, for the Lord's Supper. Communion. And once again, it's a blessing to be able to commune, even in the pandemic. Because we're doing this in remembrance of Him. My Lord. The scripture reading comes from 1 Corinthians 11, 23, and I'm going to read all the way to 34. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After the same manner, also he took the cup when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as ye drink it in remembrance of me. At 26, for as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do shew the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. It's real, y'all. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. Wherefore, my brethren, when ye come together to eat, tarry one for another. And if any man hunger, let him eat at home, and ye come not together unto condemnation, and the rest will I set in order when I come. When he comes, amen. Let's go in prayer. Father God, thank you. Thank you for this time you've given us, Lord God, to sup, to commune with you, Father God. Father God, it's all about you. It's all about him, Lord. You sent him, Father God, so that we may be saved. We do this in remembrance of him, Lord God. We ask, Father God, that you forgive us of our sins, Father God. And we thank you, Lord, that our sins didn't follow us from yesterday into today, Lord God. Father God, cleanse us, make us whole, so we can do this in remembrance of you and do it worthy unto you. We give you glory and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Mark 14, 22 through 26. And as they did eat, Jesus took bread and blessed and broke it. Take the bread. And gave to them and said, take, eat. This is my body. And he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said unto them, this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many. Verily I say unto you, I will drink no more of the fruit of the vine until that day that I drink in the new kingdom of God. And drink. Oh, hallelujah.
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 Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
We did that in remembrance of
Thank
him.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's all about
Thank you, Jesus.
Him.
Amen.
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 Thank y'all. Thank y'all
Thank
so
you.
Much. Let's give Pastor another round of
yeah.
applause for
yeah.
that awesome, awesome message.
Yeah, that was a good
it
word.
Is about him. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I also want to make an announcement before I sit down. Those who are in the adults that want to participate in Zoom, in the Zoom, we're going to do an adult Sunday school on Zoom. Can you please sign up at the table right here on your way out? Just name a number so I can contact everybody and we all be on the same page. Yeah.
And I got some Sunday school books for the teachers.
And the Sunday school books are here for all
the
teachers
youth.
As well.
For the youth.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Before we leave, amen, we are going to have a benediction. And remember, on your way out, you can drop your offering off. I think there's a basket over there. You drop it off. But it, once again, it is so good to see everyone. If everyone would stand at this time, we'll have our benediction. Everyone stand. Everyone stand.
And that's those that are able to stay to help.
And those that's able to stay to help to break down the tents. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. We just breaking down a few tents. When the Hebrew children were moving in the wilderness, they were breaking them down constantly. A bunch of tents while they were moving. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. This time we'll have a benediction. Father in heaven, we want to thank you for everything that's happened on today, Father God. We thank you, first of all, for life, health, and strength. Father, we thank you for the weather that we've had today, Father
yes,
God.
Yes.
We thank you for providing for us today, Master, and keeping all the storms and everything else away. Father, we thank you for all those that were here to be a part of this worship service, and we thank you for all of those that were praying and then the scripture reading, Father God, the praise team, Father God, the opening prayer and all the prayers that happened on today, and for from the prayer of the saints also that are in the audience, Father God, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for any visitors that may have been here. Father God, we ask for a direction that you lead whosoever will in the way that you have us to go, Father God. In the manner of situation with buildings or whatever we're doing, Father God, we seek you, Father God. We look to you, Master.
Thank
just
you.
Asking that you would lead, guide, and direct us, Father God.
Yes,
now, Master, we just want to say thank you once
thank
again.
You,
Modern Lady Grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us now, henceforth, and forevermore. Let the church say, Amen.
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 You're dismissed.
Amen.
Yes,
oh, once again, I forgot to thank Reverend Lewis also for the use of his sound system. Thank you, Reverend Lewis. Amen. Thank you.
Love you.